Government housing agency Kāinga Ora is wasting taxpayer money and not increasing housing stock, according to a high-profile developer. He told One News the agency is paying over the odds for land, but the government says its approach to tackling big projects is the right one. Political editor Jessica Much-Mackay has this exclusive story.
Ferncliff Farm on the outskirts of Tauranga will soon have 1,000 houses. Multiple developers tendered for it. But government agency Kāinga Ora outbid them all.
The government has lots of its own land. Why they feel the need to be in the private market outbidding private developers to buy more, I honestly don't know.
He runs Winton Property Development.
Remember that? Winton does.
He says millions of taxpayer dollars is being shelled out, but it isn't increasing housing stock because these houses would be built by developers anyway.
You've got to let the private sector get on with it because that's how you get housing delivered in this country.
There's just no evidence that the government does a better job of building houses. In fact, they've proven to be very slow. Kiwi Build is a case in point.
The price paid for this prime land is under wraps, but it's estimated by experts to be tens of millions of dollars.
For a deal this big, it needs cabinet sign-off. We also know that Treasury gave advice about the price of the farm, but because it's deemed commercially sensitive, it can't be released right now.
Housing Minister Megan Woods wasn't available for an interview today, but in a statement says Kāinga Ora cannot pay any more than 5% above its valuations. This applies to the Tauranga purchase. She says this deal will include 200 affordable houses and 200 public houses, and says it'll be affordable, warm, dry homes. Chris Meehan says the government's also holding up an Auckland development involving 5,000 homes. He applied for a fast track under the new Urban Development Act. Kāinga Ora says no, it's meant to be for projects that would otherwise struggle.
We're not asking them for one single red cent, so why not let us get on and do it?
Kāinga Ora says this is a well-funded developer seeking reduced timeframes and complexities, so they don't fit the criteria. That ruling's now being appealed. Jessica Much-Mackay, One News.